Hello friends, today we are going to discuss about designing of combinational circuits. Combinational logic circuit, before start for designing part, let us see what is combinational logic circuit. So combinational logic circuit is a circuit which gives an output depending upon the input which is being given at that particular instant. So it is a digital circuit which gives us the output based on the current input conditions, that is either logic 0 or logic 1. The combinational circuit consists of input variables, logic gates and output variables as shown in this block diagram. Input n inputs, combinational circuit is there which consists of different logic gates and m number of outputs. Now there are different types of combinational logic circuits. So let us see the different types and few of them we are going to discuss today for designing part. So combinational logic circuits are basically designed in these three parts or three types: arithmetic and logical functions, data transmission and code converters. So the combinational circuit come under the category of arithmetic and logical functions are such as adders, subtractors, comparators, PLDs. Then combinational logic circuits which come under data transmission category are multiplexers, demultiplexers, encoders, decoders. And combinational logic circuits come under the code converters are binary to decimal, BCD to decimal and 7 segment or BCD to 7 segment decoders. So these are the different types of combinational logic circuits which are very helpful in designing these different systems, which are basic functions of the different electronic gadgets or the different electronic systems. Now there are different steps for designing a combinational logic circuits. Let us see what are the steps one by one. So first of all, to start with the combinational designing of combinational logic circuit, we have to first of all see the specifications of the circuit and we have to see what are the number of inputs required for that achieving that specifications and what can be the possible outputs required. So in that way we have to decide what are the number of inputs and what are the number of outputs. Then after deciding the number of input variables and output variables, we have to write a truth table which is defining the relationship between the input and output. So this relationship establishing truth table is very, very essential. Once the truth table is developed, depending upon the relationship between the input and output variables, we have to obtain a simple simplified Boolean function using a K-map or any other possible technique by the way of which we can find out a simplified Boolean expression or Boolean function for that specific truth table which is specified or which is find out for the required circuit. Once the simplified Boolean function is obtained from the K-map, we have to draw a logic diagram and then we have to verify the correctness of the design. So this is the general procedure for designing any combinational logic circuit. Now let us start with one example of combinational logic circuit, which is very very much preferably used in almost all the ALUs and all. So that particular circuit is nothing but a full adder circuit. So basically full adder is nothing but a electronics digital circuit which adds or which performs the addition of two bits with one carry. That means it is giving us the addition of three binary bits. So let us consider the three binary bits x, y and z suppose, and the result of this three bits addition can be written as output variables as carry and sum, that is C and S. So that way we have three input variables and two output variables. Now we are, because of the three input variables, the possible combination of all these three input variables can be written here or can be summarized in this table as 8 total possible conditions, right from 000 to 111. And for every combination, we have written the outputs, which are carry and sum outputs. Now this is our truth table. Now we have to put this truth table in a K-map so that we can easily find out the simplified Boolean expression for this truth table. So if we put this in the K-map, the K-map for sum output and the K-map for carry output. So these are the two K-maps which are being designed or which are being written for the above truth table. So for sum output, we have these particular conditions, or the K-map will come like this. Here we have a X variable, here we have a YZ variable. In the same manner for carry output, we have this type of K-map. Now from this K-map, we can write the simplified expression just by the way of reducing the K-map or K-map reduction technique. And we have this K-map reduction technique, or by here we have using the pair combination, and here the single one is available. So we have written the expression according to this. So if we have, for example, this one, so in this particular for this particular one, the expression will be X, Y, and Z, and so on we can have these different terms. In the same manner, here also we have paired the ones. So as we have formed three pairs, so we have three simplified terms: X, Y plus X, Z plus Y, Z. So these are the expressions for sum and carry. Once we have got this expression, let us simplify it further. So when you simplify it further, or when we simplify it further, we got the terms like Z, X or Y, X or X, or Z, X or X, X or Y. And in the same way, here also we got the simplified term in this manner. So once you got this particular equation, now it is very easy or very simple to draw a circuit based on this particular way, Boolean expression. So the implementation of the circuit can be seen here. So this is the full adder implemented in SOP form, means the implementation of full adder in sum of products form. So here we have taken all the terms, and as these terms are ANDed, so this is the AND gate, and then all these four terms are being ORed. So here we have a four input OR gate. Similarly, carry term, so each of this term is ANDed, and then further they are ORed together to form a carry. So this is the sum output and this is the carry output. So one can put the different combinations of inputs over here, and one can check the correctness of this design circuit as per the truth table, or from the truth table it can be verified. So this is the way how we can simply design a full adder circuit with a in a soft form with basic gates. Furthermore, we can also modify this design by simply using the XOR gate. So if we use a XOR gate, the complexity of circuit is or the circuit become less complex, or we can say the less number of gates are being used in this circuit compared to the previous one. If you compare here, you need more gates, while here you only 5 gates are being used, and we can design a same full adder circuit or implemented full adder circuit, which will give you the sum term and carry term, which can be verified again from the truth table. So this is the way how we can design a simple combinational circuit which is a full adder. Now let us see another example, which is from transmission or data transmission type of combinational circuit. Here we have a decoder. Decoder is the circuit that decodes the coded word, that is called M to N line decoder, where M is less than or equal to 2 raised to the power N. So this is the relation between the inputs and output. The decoder is also used as code converter, such as BCD to 7 segment, binary to decimal, etc. So let us consider 3 to 8 line decoder. So again we have a possible 8 combinations of 3 inputs, that is by using different combinations. Here we can write a truth table. Okay, so every time for a selected input we have 7 outputs possible, but the only one is being activated at the time and the rest of remain 0. So according to this we have written the different entries. We have written the different entries here, and again by using a SOP term equation or a sum of product term equation, or by using even a K-map, we can simplify this expression. So for example, here we have written the SOP term, sum of product term. So this product term is being written for this particular input combination 001. So as we know, the 0 are taken as a complemented inputs and 1 is taken as a uncomplemented input. So we have here the x dash, y dash and z. So x complement, y complement and z is the min term value for this particular input condition. In the same way we can write it for all these ones which are highlighted over here. Okay, and then once we write the all min terms for this particular ones, then we can implement the circuit by using the basic logic gates. So here you can see the implementation of all these terms which are being written for each of this one, and thus we got the implementation of the 3:8 decoder circuit. So this way various other combinational logic circuits such as multiplexer, demultiplexer, code converters can, etc., can be designed by using this technique. So here we stop the discussion. Let us see the other combinational circuits designing in the next part. Thank you.